my lab focuses on, actually our whole unit focuses on, is trying to control specific diseases to chickens. As you can imagine, people like to eat chickens. And here in the US, just a bit of trivia, we process 1 million birds per hour. And so it's very important to control diseases because the birds are grown in high intensity areas. If there's an infectious disease, you can imagine that they spread rather easily from one bird to another. So the industry mainly relies on what we would call biosecurity. So they want to keep the living conditions of the birds in very clean. And they also then rely on other control measures. In particular, what we work on are two things. One, our vaccination, as well as my more interest is on genetic resistance. So what I try to do is make birds more resistant. In particular, the one disease that I work on is known as Marek's disease, which is, you know, from a technical term, it's actually a herpes virus that causes T-cell lymphoma, so it causes cancers in birds. So obviously, if you're a meat-type bird and you get this disease, you're going to get tumors and you're unfit for human consumption. And if you're an egg-type chicken and you get the disease, well, then you stop laying eggs, and so that's not a good thing. And so that's what our lab focuses on, is trying to improve, basically, animal health, and in this case, chickens. That we generate a lot of data. So this is very common now in the field known as genomics, is that one performs a lot of DNA or RNA sequencing to be able to characterize either the genome of the individual or the what are known as the RNA or the transcripts of the individual. And so you generate lots and lots of data, and consequently you need to be able to have ways to be able to analyze it, and that's where we need the high performance computer capacity that's available through the HPCC. Many of my students have taken advantage of the in-house counseling or service that are provided, so they've been very helpful. They've also been very helpful when we've needed to install particular special programs. They've been very helpful. It's just been wonderful to have this facility here. I think it's rather unique because I do collaborate with a lot of other people at various universities, and they don't seem to have this kind of level of support. So I think MSU is very lucky to have this sort of overall service facility that's provided.